Hello, you lovely lot. Now, as I mentioned in the last video, which should be uploaded by now, I did mention about my taste today, and let's just say it wasn't very well organized, as I'll put it politely. So, you're thinking, what went wrong? What went wrong? They're not so organized. If you went to my college, they're not organized. So basically, what happened is, I went to college, I told my name, I went, hi, Jonathan Cayley, because Johnny is short for Jonathan. And I said, oh, we don't have you. I was like, what? And I said, well, why don't you go to student services? And I started thinking, oh, great, this is going to be brilliant. This is going to be. I'm gonna be losing my temper at the end of the day. So they said, right, go back to reception, go to the theatre, and I was getting so confused, I was getting so annoyed. And I said, look, you're just, I'm getting fed up with this. I'm getting told one thing, the next thing I'm getting told a different thing. So basically, luckily someone from Performing Arts Bill unit said to me, are you right? I was like, no, I'm a little bit confused actually. And I don't know what happened, but luckily I found where I was meant to go. Thank you very much, staff, for not helping me. But they told me to keep going, like, go to student services, go back to reception, go back to student services. Go to the theatre. And I didn't know what the hell I was meant to be doing. I didn't know where to go. And the thing is, like, they didn't have me down, so, like, they could have. I was in college on the Friday. They could have said to my tutor at that time, oh, they don't have your name. Can you tell them your name so that they can write it down for Monday? That would have been fine. But leave it till actually on the Monday, where they knew that I was coming in, because if anyone's starting a different course in college, you're pretty much bound to be in college on that day, meeting your tutor, meeting the people that's going to be in your course, and potentially meeting your other half. But there's this woman at the student services, and it's like, oh, have you, don't get too frustrated. I was like, I'm losing the will to live, and then she was laughing, I think. I can't really remember that well, but I do know it was a massive, massive disaster. I was getting really annoyed. I was getting absolutely, like, really, really, yeah, I was getting really, really annoyed. Thank you, Sky, for interrupting me. But yeah, I wasn't very happy at all because it was very, very unorganized and they didn't know what the hell to do. But I remember it was about, oh, 2 weeks before I went to college. This bear in mind, it was on a Wednesday and I had to go up to my workplace on a Wednesday, so I thought, I'm going to tell them I'm a little bit late. But luckily, I was actually on time. It took about 10 minutes. And, what happened was I was there already. So I was just in there. The English teacher at the time said, you know what? I was thinking, I said, no, I'm actually still waiting for someone. Thinking, some of this should have been here by now. So I got this. I don't know if you watch EastEnders, but it was the kind of man who looked like he was from EastEnders, the Latvian one. And so yeah, I had him, which was brilliant. Not. And there's the. You have student cards if you're in code. And it's like, oh, do you know your number? I was like, what? Wait, what? Your number? I was like, And I was like, I don't know what you mean. So, like, how'd you get into college? I was like, thinking, well, I think I actually said, well, you should have described it a bit better. I should have done that, but honestly, I didn't give a flying fuck. Because if he said, oh, do you have the number that's on your card? Do you know your number that's on your card? I said, oh, yeah, it's this and 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 this number. And and I didn't know why I was going to college. I was like thinking, hang on, I'm going to be in my workplace, and so why have you dragged me into college? And my tutor at the time said, oh, you're just filling out forms. I was like, I don't know what I'm filling out forms for. Am I going to the Navy? The Army? Am I being deported? Am I like, I was gonna say something, but I thought, no, better not. So I stopped. I was like, am I signing up for something that I don't know what I'm signing up for? Do I need to, like, read the small print? They didn't tell me anything. I was really confused when I was in college. And then my form tutor was like, oh, no, you're just actually signing something. It won't take long. I was thinking, well, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you tell me? I didn't understand. I was like, ugh. And I still don't understand to this day. But that's done and dusted, I suppose. But it's just really annoying me. I was like, what? So, who the hell do you think you're talking to? Because if you get into an argument with me, you will most likely lose, because I'll just say some things, some hurtful things, but I'll just say things. And if I was actually genuinely sorry, then I wouldn't say it, but otherwise I wouldn't give a flying shit. Okay, I just want to point out, I'm literally on my phone, and it's this is 44%. How? Yeah, I mean, I've used my phone a lot, but how is that 44? But yeah, it was just so disorganized. I didn't have a clue. Nobody told me anything. So obviously I am gonna be a bit pissed off if nobody has ever told me anything about what's gonna happen on the Monday. Or just with the course in general. All I know is 4 days a week, I have one day off, I might be going to London a fair bit, to go, like, to theatres, maybe, like, to the Hammersmith and all that. I don't know what's actually happening. But, yeah, it wasn't very organised, and I remember last year, there was this pre-enrollment thing, which was a massive disaster. Looking back at it now, I can laugh at it, but at the time, it wasn't so funny. And that was the pretty much sole reason why I was put on the internship course. What happened was, I was allegedly on the performance course. And there was a girl there, on the taste stand, she said, there was a problem last year, I was meant to be doing it, but they said they weren't doing it. And I thought, that's the exact same problem that I had. I was like thinking, she just literally said what I was thinking. But she just gave some really random answers. So I can't remember what she said, but so me and my mum sat down And then within about a minute or so, there's bitch of a woman come out and she said, "We're not doing performing arts." And we just looked and went, "What?" And then I was shouting, I was crying, I was like thinking, "Oh my bloody God." And I was so annoyed. And I spent the majority of my summer last year figuring out which college I should go to. The one in Benfleet, which I've been going to since I was 16, or Southend. I mean, yeah, I've been to Southend, but with someone. I haven't been on my own, and I'm a bit petrified and a bit scared if I get at the wrong stop, because I do tend to do that. Like, I'll press stop at the wrong stop, and then I'll just literally be like, that was a mistake. But yeah, it wasn't funny at the time, but now I can just think, oh, that was quite hilarious actually. But no, it wasn't funny at the time. I didn't. So this is like. So now I was like 17 years old. I was really confused. I was thinking, do I go to Southend College or do I stay in Benfleet? So I was having a meeting in Benfleet one day. Then I was going to Southend, and I was torn between two. And then the one in Southend said, "Oh, because you haven't got a D in English, I have an E in English, I think. E for English." They said they won't accept me. But if I do choose to reapply to Southend College, and if I get a D in English, they won't have to audition me because I'm so brilliant. So they told me that, nah. They didn't say like that, it's like, just because, it's solely because you've got a D in English. Other than that, we would love to have you. But, I didn't understand it. People at Southend, they were much more organised, and, they understood my struggle, and, but taking their time out to, like, to interview me, saying that, okay, because you're having this kind of troubles, Benfleet College, I'm not gonna say name because I did that last time and it was stupid. Especially if they watch this. I don't think college should be watching this at all, actually. But it's just, oh. So on the 20th, which is when I'm next going back in, so it's literally about 2 weeks on Wednesday. I'm gonna be there for about an hour, so I'm guessing that's the pre-room there, which I'm absolutely shaming myself for, just in case it happens again, and I might have to punch somebody in the face, and that means I won't see the guy I have a crush on. I gave him a fake name. I think it was like Tyrone. It was something unique. Yeah, I think it was Tyrone. I can't remember. Can someone watch the video then comment saying, "Oh, you gave this person this name"? But I just did it to save for embarrassment, really, if you watch this video. So, yeah, I just feel like I've been to, this would be my third course, and I've been going since I was 16. So when I left school at 16, I was doing one course, then I did the internship course, and then I'm doing this course, and then I'm thinking, okay, do I do one more course, or do I just leave altogether? Because I might try and do like a journalism course, like a journalism course, which would be really, really really good because I'm into like journalism anyway. It's kind of like media, and I love media at school. So if they do that, then I might do that next year, and then I'll just leave college before I'm 20, not after 20. Wait, I'm getting myself confused. So I think maybe one more course, and then I'll leave college forever. But that'll make me. I would have to get a permanent job. And that's when maybe I'll try to do some gigs and then eventually do Britain's Got Talent, because I'm still trying. If they have these sheets and say, "Oh, suggest the club," I'll with no hesitation write my name, and it's just like comedy, and then I'll just got to figure out who to put it to, or I could suggest it to someone who's in the performing arts unit, maybe my tutor, because why not? There's a theatre, there's microphones, we just need comedians and some materials. We could do that live at the Apollo, like someone could be hosting, then someone could do like a 2 minute joke, like their routine for like a couple minutes, and then someone else would come out and then dab at the end. So it is literally just like, so it's like you got the host and then they talk about 15 minutes and then, or something like that, I can't remember how long they talk for, I haven't watched it in like ages. And then they get the first act out and they do their routine for about 5 minutes or like a couple, not that long, and then they go away and then the host introduces the second act and then they go away into the wings somewhere and then they do their bit, like second act does their act and then they go away and then they close the show and then yeah, I could definitely see that happening. I mean that low yeah, I next time I'm gonna see her, I'm definitely gonna suggest that. And I'll say it in front of my mum because I've been meaning to say something about a comedy club at college, but I haven't got round to it, and thought, ooh, maybe when I go back to college on the 20th, and if I see her, yeah, if I actually bump into her, I might suggest it in front of my mum, and then she'll be like, she says, oh, they won't be there. It's like, no, I mean, like, as a lunchtime club, like, be like, yeah, it's a lunchtime club, and then, like, we can just like put our version of Live at the Apollo whenever we're not busy, so like the comedy club people can like put on like a little showcase and like because don't know how it'd be figured out, but we will make it work. But it's gonna happen. It's going to happen. I will make sure that there's a comedy club at college because I need to get experience and I need to go and do some gigs. And the sooner I do gigs, the sooner I get experience, the sooner I can do gigs, and then the sooner I can do Britain's Got Talent. And that's the main thing I want to do, is do Britain's Got Talent as a comedian because apparently I'm really funny and I've got some material. I've shown you my notebook, I'm not showing you again because it's effort. As much as I love you, as much as I love you, yes, effort came in that book. But yeah, yeah, this will happen. This will happen before September, hopefully. This will definitely happen before December. I guarantee you that. Before December 2014, I will make sure that there's a comedy club at college because I need to get experience because then I need to do gigs and then more gigs will lead me to do, will help me get more experience and then I can eventually do Britain's Got Talent and then debate whether to do a journalism course or just leave college altogether. I don't know. I don't know. But yeah, the sooner I can do it, the sooner that I can just like apply for Britain's Got Talent. Maybe not next year, but maybe the year after, so that when I'm 20, I'll be 20 years old and be on Britain's Got Talent, which is epic. So if that happens, I think like next June, I'll say to my mum, "Oh, do you think that I should apply for Britain's Got Talent?" Because obviously, with the Comedy Club, and obviously, there's some. I might be doing some gigs next year, not too sure what's happening with the gigs. But with the comedy club at college and performing arts, do you reckon I should give it a go? And she's like, yeah, give it a go. And then I'll apply, and then I'll turn up, and then hopefully I'll be on TV. That is my aim. To do a comedy club, hopefully people will sign up because some people I do find amusing. And I want to do a Live at the Apollo kind of thing. It's going to happen, okay? I'll guarantee you that. It's going to happen. And I'll say it in front of my mum, and the sooner it can happen, the sooner that I can eventually get my ass to apply for Britain's Got Talent. Yeah, it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. But I don't know when the thingy. I think it closes like December, so it needs to happen soon. So yeah, I'm gonna leave you, and that's my rant over. So here's a heart, and I'm gonna leave you. Bye.